and at last back in the All Blacks. Number 15, fullback today, Laurie Mains. First played for New Zealand in 1971. Just checking the teams for you again. The New Zealand team, two new caps, Davis and Purvis. There they are, no new players in their team. Jimmy Davidson, number 7, the replacement forward, flown out specially for this match. Interesting to note that the Irish, having won the toss, will play into the wind. A haka from the All Blacks. Final instructions from Andy Leslie after the haka was led by Bill Bush. We saw the haka in Auckland last year before the Scotland match, but that's the first time it's been seen at Athletic Park by the All Blacks for many years. But conditions excellent for the playing of this test match. Referee Tom Ducey starts the test match, the first ever in New Zealand featuring the emerald green of Ireland. John Robbie back to Barry McGann. Neil Purvis, the brand new All Black.
H-O-J, I want it cut. No time for H-O-J.
Tension is on. We can hear it. They can obviously feel it. Peter Whiting, back in test rugby, gets the palm. Robertson, not a good one. Davidson, number 7, is the brand new Irish flanker on this tour. He was quick to that. Now it's Pat Whelan throwing. Deep. Ken Stewart. 12 is Lynn Jeffrey. Leslie. The whistle has gone. Robbie. Away to McGann. Ireland running it. That's a good kick. Mains. A very good kick by McGann. Under the bar. Mains had to catch it with the post very close. This is within the Irish defensive zone. McKinney. He doesn't believe it. Penalty, and it could have been for hands in the scrum. And this is a handy angle for Otago's Laurie Mains. This is where New Zealand could take the lead. A left-footed kick coming up from Laurie Mains. That's one that will be a particular satisfaction to Mains. For 5 long years, he's been out of the All Blacks test team. Back again today, he puts them in the lead. 3-0 after 13 minutes. And standing off. A planned move coming up. Willie Duggan at halfway. Leslie. Ireland have got a lot of tricks up their sleeve today. Now the All Blacks challenge with the crowd's approval. Kirkpatrick. 10 metres into Irish territory. Robbie's kick directly to touch. Doing his boot up, and he's gone right back to an extra fullback position. Ken Stewart's dropped off, so they match up. Kirkpatrick. Davis. Jeff Rader, Bruce Robinson, Ryan Williams. It's Tanner who's jumping against Phil O'Callaghan. Davidson and Stewart, the two number sevens. Kinney, number six. McGann and Master. Good surge by Ron Haken, number four. O'Callaghan, Robbie, 13 is McElroy. McGann, McMaster. Haynes. Number three in the lineout, Willie Duggan, who normally jumps down the back. Nearly got it, it's gone to Davis. Robertson, Jeff Gray, Williams in but left out, Bruce Robertson 30, Stewart number 7, a central position, Davis, Purvis, the two new players. Not really a running chance there for Neil Purvis, but it... Lynn Davis. Way to Robertson. Bounced nicely for Mains. Robertson! Bruce Robertson! Here it comes. The pass from Robertson was not a good one, but Mains ran onto the pass. And then when Bruce Robertson got it, the way was clear. So Bruce Robertson, number 13, has scored. New Zealand 7, Ireland 0. Remains kicking with the assistance of the wind. Three loose balls for Ireland. Duggan, Davidson. That's their strength in the balls. Again, this is the first time they've shifted the ball. Ensor in. But he didn't use the overlap to Tom Grace. Gibson. Haynes and McMasters. Williams. Ensor. Haynes under this one. Jeff Ray changed his mind. Davis, Robertson. All Blacks playing with confidence. McGann. Remember, they only have the win for 5 more minutes, and it could be increasing, turning it into a decided advantage to the team who will play with it in the second half. Kerry Tanner, number 3. Open, with him, Kirkpatrick. Bill Bush in support. Tanner feeds Davis, Robertson. Jeff Ray, Mains in. Bruce Robertson flicking on to Purvis. Neil Purvis caught by Grace. Stewart there. Now Jeff Ray. All the South Islanders handling. Purvis. Davis. Jeff Ray. Bruce Robertson. Wheeling the cross and cover. But Bruce Robertson's hand on the ball nudged it forward. The big county centre, 6'1", 13.5 stone. Whelan, guided back by McKinney, the flanker. This is only 10 metres out from Ireland's line. Davis has it. Kirkpatrick. Nowhere to go, but over the top. Try for Ian Kirkpatrick. Lynn Davis was the man that smuggled the ball from the back of the Irish scrum. And then it was a simple hand to Ian Kirkpatrick. And the big flanker was over with a high dive, handy to the post. Ian Kirkpatrick's 47th try. Mains. That was a bad miss for Mains from a handy kick. So he's having his moments, both good and bad. ...of the wind in the second half. Bill Bush feeding Andy Leslie in there playing halfback. Right on half-time, New Zealand with 14 men. Leslie, kicking high for Ansa, they're all chasing. Knocked forward by the Irish fullback. To that kick by Andy Leslie, playing at halfback. And if Lynn Davis cannot return, shortly we'll see Sid going. Question is the second half begins, is 11 points enough to hold back an Irish team? And that must be racing through the mind of this man, New Zealand's captain Andy Leslie. Mike Gibson started the second half with a kick to the opposite corner of the field. The All Blacks must be totally dedicated in this half if they are to win against an Irish team that is holding its own. What a roar, the first time going, held the ball. Great sympathy for Lynn Davis, but at the same time, a lot of pleasure at seeing Sid going on the field. To start the second half by Laurie Mains, who began this game so well, but faded a little in the end of the first half.
WAX,
what a catch! Robbie let that one bounce. Again, Gibson running right up to his opposites to give Insel the overlap. McMaster there. McElrath. McMaster. That move looked ominous for the All Blacks. The Irish backs moving the ball with confidence. Robertson and going. Duggan. He's played so well. See whether Gary Owen means a high kick. I doubt it, this position at the 22-meter line. Williams. Two big men, both of them close on 18 stone each. John Robbie. McGann. Mains under pressure. Jeffrey. Kick out again by Robertson. Haken. Helping him and assisting is Mosky number 5. Robbie away to McGann. Gibson. Insaw in. McElrath, McMaster. But a royal chance missed by Wallace McMaster. Maybe the fifth. Kick out from the 22 from the All Blacks. Variation was needed. Gibson. Gibson, where's he going? Grace. 20 metres out. Ireland in possession. O'Callaghan, McKinney, the great mauler. Out to McGann. McElrath, McMaster. Ensor. Forward pass ruled. Well, that discussion before must have been the final warning, and the New Zealand front row has been penalised. Andy Leslie just checking with Mr. Ducey the reason for that penalty. But this is a simple shot for Barry McGann, 22 metres out. Ireland on the board, 11-3. Sid going. Back to Robertson. Bruce Robertson. Stewart is handy. McDonald going. Away to Duncan Robertson. Then Jeffrey. Maines in. Got the ball. McElrath. He knows that Maines was up in the attack. Duncan Robertson. Ireland may go for a try. Obviously a converted try would put them closer to the All Blacks. Duggan, caught by Stewart. McKinney in support for the feed. Robbie. How many times is this that the All Blacks have been back at the 22? Peter Whiting, what a return to test match for him today. Now Kirkpatrick, the try scorer. Phil Orr. Duggan on to Purvis. The Irish team have it. Robbie McGann. Gibson. McElrath. Ensor. McMaster. 10 metres into New Zealand territory. Jeffrey. Ian Kirkpatrick again is captain in support. Good work by Keane in the maul. McElrath at fly hard. Gibson, he could run Tom Grace into position. What a tackle by Duncan Robertson. Sid going. Halfway. Sid going. Neil Purvis. And Leslie. Going. Robertson. Williams and Ensor. Gets away from Williams. Look at the twinkling toes of Tony Ensor. Robbie. Sid going made the tackle on halfway. Robbie. Duggan. Less than 20 metres to go. Keane, good work again. Robbie. Again, Gibson. Grace. Interception by Jeffrey. Tony Ensor. Leslie. Stewart. Going. Now the All Black team arriving.
Up we go, Moss.
Hold.
Going. Robertson, Jaffray, Ryan Williams, Bruce Robertson, Ken Stewart is there, Williams, Stewart, 10 metres out, Sid going, Duncan Robertson, Jaffray, Mains, Purvis, Duncan Robertson looking for the bounce. Hoisting high, Robbie, what a brilliant catch. The Gary Owen Club. McKinney, Robbie, McGann, Gibson, Enser in, Stewart and Jaffray the tacklers. Keane, all 18 stone of it. Whelan, Robbie, McGann, Gibson, McElrath, Grace versus Purvis. McElrath's kick, Haken, Duggan, Willie Duggan, 10 metres out. Just over 1 minute to go. Robbie, the way to Grace. He got the bounce. McMaster. Leslie. Tony Enso. He has Gibson. Gibson. Bill Bush. This could be the last chance of the match. But the game looks safe for the All Blacks at 11-3, but the Irish team desperately wishing to score a try. Going, Duggan. Into injury time, this will be... That is the end of the match. New Zealand 11 and Ireland 3. So Ireland's desperate second half attempt to score tries failed, and the All Blacks held on to their two tries and a penalty goal scored in the first half. And full marks to an Irish team that played with great pride this afternoon.